Well, I am a day late, but I like to say better late than never. It's Judah Brody here to give you a dose of the NFL. This was the first time in 53 years of Super Bowls that the cities matched up were the same as the World Series. First, if I could describe it in one word, it would be snooze fest. Or is that two words? No offense to those that like defensive football, pun unintended, but there was only a combined 16 points in the game. This was the lowest scoring Super Bowl in history. In fact, there were only four scoring plays. Let's count them down. One 49-yard field goal for the Patriots by Steven Gostkowski in the second quarter left the score 3-0 in the favor of the Pats at halftime. The Rams followed up with a 53-yard field goal by Greg Zuerlein in the third quarter. A quarter later, we finally saw the first and only touchdown of the game after a stunning 29-yard catch by Rob Gronkowski allowed the Patriots to get close enough to run the ball 2 yards, scoring 6, and they also got the extra points, making it 10-3 Patriots. The Rams got all the way to the Patriots' 27-yard line, but after a failed pass to the end zone, the ball was intercepted, and the Patriots' Gostkowski came in with another field goal, this time 41 yards, which led to a final score of 13-3. The missed field goal also happened after, but let's move past it. The Rams have gotten beat enough and up tonight. Tom Brady picked up his 5th Super Bowl ring, and the Pats' 6 Super Bowl wins ties them with the Steelers for most in any NFL franchise. The Patriots dynasty continued on Sunday. It'll be another year before anyone gets the chance to dethrone him. Until then, I'm Judah Brody reporting for DPNews. Really, guys, the Super Bowl wasn't even on Fox this year. It was on Also, if you can't get enough of me and this Super Bowl, there is more exciting action-packed segment available on the DP News YouTube.